Good morning. In this session, we will take some of the examples for the application of Ampere's circuital law. A long straight wire of a circular cross section, a long straight wire of circular cross section. Of radius a carries a steady current I. The current is uniformly distributed across the cross section. The current is uniformly distributed across the cross section. Apply Ampere's circuital law. Apply Ampere's circuital law to calculate the magnetic field at a point on the region for question number A, R less than A, question number B, R greater than A. Let me read once. A long straight wire of circular cross section of radius A carries a steady current I. The current is uniformly distributed across the cross section. Apply Ampere's circuital law to calculate the magnetic field at a point on the region R less than A, R greater than A. Now given as a straight wire of circular cross section, and this wire carries a current I, and this current is uniformly distributed over the cross section. Now we have to find out what is the magnetic field inside the conductor and outside the conductor. The meaning of R less than A is inside the conductor and R greater than A is outside the conductor. Now let us first, we will draw this circular wire. So given is a circular wire of uniform cross section, and then you know it carries a current I. So if this is your wire, and the radius of the wire is given. Okay, and this wire carries a current I. So current I is uniformly distributed. Now, given that the current is uniformly distributed, uniformly distributed across the cross section of radius R. Not radius R, radius A. Now here, to apply Ampere's circuital law, we need to find out, we need to consider closed Amperean loop. And we have to find out what is the total length of that loop, and also what is the current threading the loop or current enclosing the loop. Now, when we consider r greater than a, we'll have a loop outside the circle. And when we have this case, r less than a, we will have a circle inside the loop. And then we have to find out what is the current in that loop. So first we'll consider the case r less than a. R less than a. Therefore, you consider a loop which is loop 1, okay, or loop. This is R now, and the radius is less than a. Amperian loop for R less than a. Now to apply Ampere's circuital law, we know that let the current enclosed in the loop is I dash. Now we need to find out what is I dash, because I is the total current. Given that the current is uniformly distributed, therefore let the current enclosed is I dash. By applying Ampere's circuital law, we get B into, this we have seen this equation in the last class, B into 2 pi the length of the loop. It is a circular loop, so the total length of the loop will be equal to the circumference of the circle, and the radius is R, so it will be 2 pi R B into 2 pi R is equal to mu naught into I dash. So first let us find out what is the value of I dash in terms of I, because I is the total current flowing. Because the current is uniformly distributed, current per unit cross section is I divided by area, that is pi a square. This is the current per unit cross section. Therefore, current passing through the cross section of radius r. Current through the cross section of radius r current through the loop of cross section of radius r, because radius of that loop is r, is I dash is equal to per unit current, that is I divided by pi r square multiplied by cross section area of the loop of radius r. So this will be equal to I into r square by a square. Now therefore B into 2 pi r is equal to mu naught into I dash, which is equal to I into r square divided by a square, or B is mu naught into I into r. 1 r square, 1 r and 1 r cancel, 2 pi a square mu naught into I r divided by 2 pi a square. Or I can say that depending upon the value of r, b changes. So b is proportional to r. This is the answer for magnetic field inside the conductor. B is proportional to r. Application of law is very simple. Consider a closed loop which encloses the current, and you apply the law B into total magnetic field B into total length of the loop is equal to mu naught times the current enclosed. And here current enclosed we have to find out because we are considering only a part of the conductor, not the whole conductor. Now consider the second case where R is greater than B. R is greater than A. Case 2, R is greater than A. Now in this case, we know the loop will become, consider a loop of radius R. So here the loop, and for R greater than A. Now this loop, if you see, it encloses the whole of the conductor. The total current passing through this cross section area of radius R will be equal to I. Total current threading the loop. Or passing through the loop. Is equal to I. Therefore, B into 2 pi R is equal to mu naught times I, or B is equal to mu naught I divided by 2 pi R. B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi R. Or from this it is very clear that B is inversely proportional to R. Therefore, outside the conductor, B varies as inversely proportional to R, and inside the conductor, it varies directly proportional to R. Therefore, you can plot a graph of B versus R. How do we get it? If you plot a graph of B versus R, the radius, and let me say this is the point where R is equal to A. Up to R equal to A, your B is directly proportional to the radius, and after that it is inversely proportional. This is the portion where B is directly proportional to R, that is for R less than A, and for R greater than A we got it as B is inversely proportional to 1 by R. So these are the two cases, and this is an important sum and important application of Ampere's circuital law. How we can find out the magnetic field inside the conductor and outside the conductor. And here we have taken a case of conductor whose cross-sectional area is A and carries a current I. Inside, B is proportional to R, and outside B is inversely proportional to R.